We want to determine the second derivative of the given function. By now we know the first thing we need to do here is rewrite this radical using a rational exponent. And since this is the cube root of x to the first, we can rewrite this as x to the power of 1/3. Now one thing that can sometimes be a little bit confusing is that we just learned about the chain rule, and now we have the extended power rule that includes the chain rule stated here in red. So sometimes you may be confused about whether you need to apply the chain rule or not. And the good news is that you can always apply it, but if u prime is equal to 1, that just tells us that we didn't need to apply the chain rule. So for example, looking at this function here, if we did want to apply the chain rule, letting u equal the inner function, we would have u equal to x, and therefore u prime would be equal to 1. So this tells us that we do not have to apply the chain rule, and we can use just the basic power rule. Okay, now the goal of this problem is to find the second derivative of the given function. So the first step is to find the first derivative, and then we'll determine the derivative of the derivative to determine the second derivative. So for the first derivative, we're going to multiply by the current exponent, so we'll have 1/3 x to the, and then we'll subtract 1 to get the new exponent. So this would be 1/3 times x to the negative 2/3. Now normally we would simplify this, but since our ultimate goal is to determine the second derivative, we're going to go ahead and leave it in this form and then find the derivative of this. So the second derivative is going to be equal to the derivative of this function. So we'll have 1/3 times the current exponent of negative 2/3 times x to the negative 2/3 minus 1. So this would be negative 2/9 times x to the, this will be negative 5/3 power. Now we don't want to leave the function in this form, mainly because it has a negative exponent. So let's rewrite this using a positive exponent. Remember, you can think of this as being over 1. So if we move this to the denominator, the power is going to change to positive 5/3. So let's rewrite this as f double prime of x is equal to negative 2 all over 9x to the power of 5/3, which may be what your textbook shows as the correct answer. But since the original function was given in radical form, let's go ahead and rewrite this back in radical form. So we'd have negative 2 over 9. Now this would be the cube root of x to the fifth. But this actually does simplify. And just to review, if we have the cube root of x to the fifth, three factors of x would be a perfect cube, so this simplifies to x times the cube root of x to the second. So we can rewrite this as negative 2 all over 9x times the cube root of x squared. So it really depends on your instructor or your textbook as to which of these three forms would be expected as your final second derivative. They're all equivalent, but written in different forms. I hope this was helpful.